All that's required, Mr. Otis, is your signature on the dotted line, and Canterville Chase officially has a new owner, the Otis family of America.
Oh, did you hear that, Virginia? You're about to have a new home.
And a very strange home, Father.
Well, if everything is in order...
Stop! There's something about Canterville Chase I've not told you.
Oh, don't worry. A couple of nails in those loose floorboards and the...
No, I'm referring to the ghost.
The ghost?
The Canterville ghost, who has lived here for 3 centuries. And as most of the former owners could tell you, if they were alive, he's caused many a sleepless night for many of them. So, if you wish to change your mind...
Not on your life, sir. And I'm sure he'll love us. Everyone usually does.
Then, congratulations.
Come, Virginia.
Yes?
We're off to the U.S. today to pack up the family. We'll see you all in a few months, including your famous Canterville ghost.
Are we almost there?
Now, boys.
Did Father tell you about the ghost?
Well, I...
Well, Mrs. Umney, the Otis family will soon be arriving.
I'm sure there'll be a gentle addition to the peace and quiet of Canterville Chase.
Yes, quiet.
Faster! Go faster!
We're going as fast as we can.
Well, actually, Mother, a modern steam engine like this could reach an approximate velocity of...
Not now, Washington.
Oh, I will so miss my good friend Molly back in Kentucky.
You'll make new friends at Canterville, Virginia.
Of whom? A ghost?
This is it? This tiny place?
Really, Hiram, don't you think it's a mite small for our family and a ghost?
It's true, Father. Each family member takes up 14.5 cubic feet of space, allowing for 6.5 feet of cubic space for a ghost.
Oh, stop your jabbering, Washington. This is only the carriage house.
Yes, there ahead is Canterville Manor, our new home.
Lord Canterville, may I introduce my family? My wife, Lucretia.
Yes, how do you do?
My daughter, Virginia.
Hello.
My oldest son, Washington.
How do you do?
And our twin boys.
Hello.
Welcome to Canterville Manor, one and all. No, forgive me. This is your new housekeeper, Mrs. Umney.
How do you do?
Hi, Mrs. Umney.
Oh, my little Poppy. Who's Poppy?
He belongs to me, I'm afraid. His name is Stanley. He'll be no trouble.
Oh, it's all right, Mrs. Umney.
Our family loves dogs.
And horses.
And crawly bugs and ghosts.
Speaking of, where is he?
Yeah, where is he?
Where is who?
The Canterville ghost.
Ghost?
I believe the scientific name is ectoplasmic manifestation.
Ghost?
Boys, give me a hand with Mrs. Umney. Washington, fetch the luggage.
I'll bet nothing exciting will ever happen here.
I'm sure you'll feel chipper in the morning, Mrs. Umney.
Sorry about fainting. It's not like me.
Well, I'm sure you won't make a habit of it.
Good night, Virginia. Put out your light, Virginia.
Oh, all right. Night, Papa. Night, Mama.
Psst. Ned, you awake?
Yeah, Ted. Are you?
Yeah.
So let's get up and go.
Ghost hunting!
Oh, except one thing.
What thing? What?
Real ghosts don't go ghosting at this hour.
Huh?
They go ghosting at midnight. It's only 10 o'clock.
Oh.
Thank you. I am the ghost of Canterville Manor, condemned to rattle these noisy chains forever.
That's all very interesting, but why don't you try this bottle of Tammany Rising Sun Lubricator on those noisy chains? Follow the directions, and we can all get some sleep. Now, off to bed, all of you.
That
includes you, Virginia.
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
What's all the noise going on out here?
I am the ghost of Canterville Manor. Can't get any worse than this. I am the ghost of Canterville Manor.
Hold on, get him. Good hit, Ned. Hurry, we'll get him.
Never in 300 years of a brilliant career have I been so grossly insulted. Well, I'll have my vengeance on these modern Americans. Oh, yes, I will. For I'm not the famous and terrifying Canterville Ghost.
Oops.
Did you see the look on his face when I handed him the Rising Sun Lubricator?
He was quite taken aback. I thought he was going to jump out of his skin.
Well, technically, Mother, an ectoplasmic apparition has no skin to jump out of. You see, it's a series of vaporized energies bonded together.
Not again.
Well, I think it's a disgrace.
Well, don't be too hard on our ghostly house guest.
Not him. Them. They slingshotted that old spear with the peppermint candy I brought all the way from America.
Boys, is this true?
Will you be having soup with dumplings, Mr. Rotis?
Yes, I would like... Mrs. Omni, you look like something the cat dragged in.
Well, I had a terrible night last night, sir. Soup, sir?
Yes, with two dumplings.
Yes, sir.
Now, boys...
We're quite sorry, and it won't happen again.
How could a dumpling frighten her?
Oh, Mrs. Omni, you're looking worse by the minute.
Oh, poor Mrs. Omni.
You march right upstairs and get back into your bed.
I would,
And we're going to take some bicarbonate for that dreadful tummy of yours. Oh, such moaning. Quickly now, no arguments. Now you take a nice nap so you can get some color back into your cheeks. Oh, you're pale as a ghost.
Virginia, why don't you take the boys outside and play with them?
But they're such babies.
We're not babies, are we? No.
Well, I have Mrs. Omni all tucked in. Oh, Mrs. Omni, what are you doing here?
Serving soup, Mom.
Well, I declare, you just march yourself back upstairs and into that bed where I put you.
How could you put me in my bed? I've been in the kitchen.
That's an order.
Ms. Otis is right.
Now, march, march.
First I was in the kitchen, then I was in my bed, she says. Then I was making dumplings, and now I'm going back to bed.
That woman's at it again.
Six red-blooded, healthy people in this house, and all I can scare is one ninny of a housekeeper and a dog. Of course, the walking headless armor in the night. Scare the pantaloons off Sir Pemberley in 1874.
Oh, if that's Mrs. Omni again.
What in heaven's name? I think it's you-know-who without his extremities.
It's no such thing. It's that ghost without his arms and legs.
Father, it's the twins. They're really too much.
Boys, collect his pieces and put him back together.
You see, technically, what happened is when an abstract mass traveling at a speed faster than it is dense...
Now, Washington, there you are, back together again and good as... well, almost good as...
You ghosts have nightmares. Maybe that's what this is. A terrible nightmare.
I'm the Canterville ghost, and I'm very scary.
Ooh. You're not. You're too ugly to be a ghost.
So are you.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Hey, come back here!
Boys, stop this roughhousing.
All right, boys. Outside with you.
We'll play hide-and-seek in the garden.
Father, look at this picture.
And what have we here?
Well, it's Sir Simon, Father.
Sir Simon?
Yes. He's the Canterville ghost. This is the way he looked when he was young. Wasn't he handsome? Oh, and look, he's with his wife.
Wasn't she beautiful? They look so happy together. They must have had a long, wonderful life.
Oh, no, Father. I've been reading the Canterville family history. She died very young.
Well, maybe that's why he's so mean and nasty now.
Maybe he feels very lonely.
It could be, my darling. It could be.
Drat them.
How dare they pry into my life? Enough of this nonsense. Tonight we pull out all the stops. Right, men? With something special like you, one-eyed Red Reuben. Oh, no, called Gideon. Yes, you, the bloodsucker.
Where do you see what Washington cooked up for that old ghost?
Boys, maybe you should not tease the ghost for a while. I mean, Sir Simon may be a ghost, but he's also a human being with feelings.
Technically, he ceased having human emotions when he ceased being a human 300 years ago. Now he's just a plasmatic phantom with not a care in the world.
Ah, I know. It's up to you, the suicide skeleton, or better yet, Martin the maniac. No, wait, the corpse snatcher of Chelsea Barn. No, no. I'll go with one of my most remarkable impersonations. A horrible huntsman of ugly warts. Yes, I'll reduce Mr. and Mrs. Otis to puddles of fear. I'll strike terror in the babbling fool Washington and those terrible twins. Ah, yes, I'll have them running, screaming into the night. Yes, I will. And as for Virginia... Well, I may not have time for her, but they'll all be begging for mercy after this night. Oh, yes. You'll quiver and quake. You'll not be the same once you awake.
Bless you.
Thank you.
Would you like a hot water bottle or some nice warm milk?
No, thank you. It's very kind of you all the same. And you're much nicer than the rest of your horrid, rude, vulgar family.
Stop! It's you who are horrid, rude, and vulgar.
Me?
You've made no attempt to make us feel welcome at all. Mm. Rattling chains and groaning through keyholes.
I was only doing my job. Ghosting's my only reason for existing. I'm doomed to walk the halls of Canterville. I always have. I always will. I can never stop. I can never cease. I'll never know a moment's peace.
But why? Has it something to do with your wife?
300 years ago, on an icy wintry evening, we had an argument at a fancy ball. She took the carriage and left without me. I made no attempt to stop her. That's what I should have done. I loved her. The horses were just too strong for her. I knew that. We found her the next morning. The carriage had fallen off a bridge, and she had drowned.
Oh, well, it was an accident?
Yes, but everyone knew I was to blame. Her family never forgave me.
Oh.
Not even years later when I passed away. They placed my body in an unmarked grave. No one ever said goodbye to me. Not a man, not a woman, not even a child.
Oh, my.
I fear I'll never see the beautiful garden where the nightingale sings all night long and where the grass grows long and deep. My beautiful and final resting place.
How do you get to this beautiful garden, huh?
First, I need someone to go with me to my gravesite to say the goodbyes that were never said. And weep the tears that were never wept.
I'll go with you.
Virginia, I'm a ghost. Come with me, you need to make a very hard journey.
Oh, I don't mind hard journeys. I traveled the Atlantic Ocean twice.
Virginia, you're only a child. I can't ask
you. I may only be a child, but if you'll pardon my saying so, beggars can't be choosers, Sir Simon. And unless the twins get a change of heart, which I seriously doubt, probably your very last chance.
Thank you, Virginia.
Oh, is it a very far journey? Shall I have Mrs. Umney pack us a lunch?
No, Virginia, it's not far. It's on the other side of the here, but not quite as far as the there. Give me your hand.
Has harmed one hair on her head, Hiram.
I know. Oh. I know.
We're almost there, Virginia.
Oh. Poor Simon. Hidden away here all these years with no one to bid you farewell. So I shall say it. Farewell, Sir Simon. At last you passed on to your beautiful garden.
Excuse me.
Oh.
Apparently we forgot something. I'm still here.
Well, what we forgot is forgiveness.
Then tell me you forgive me and be quick.
No, not my forgiveness, Sir Simon. Yours. You must forgive yourself.
What?
What happened was an accident. It wasn't your fault. You'll never find your beautiful garden unless you believe that.
But how do I forgive myself?
You've lost. All the yesterdays you loved so, but they're gone, and you must let go.
Yes, of course. Oh, look, Virginia. The garden. The beautiful garden. Goodbye, Virginia. And thank you for caring about me. Oh, also say farewell to your family, and yes, even the twins.
Goodbye, Sir Simon. Rest in peace.
Mama!
Papa! It's Virginia!
Virginia! Thank goodness our prayers were answered. What happened?
Oh, I've had a most wonderful adventure, Mother. And tomorrow all of you will help me complete the adventure.
What do you think, Virginia?
Oh, it's a beautiful marker, Father.
Farewell, Sir Simon, and rest in peace.
Yes, and try and stay put.
Guys, you poor darlings.
Who are we going to have to tease now?
Come back to the car now.